Hey Windowers, and welcome to another episode of Windows on Windows, part of the series on the development of Windows XP. In this bonus video, we'll be taking a look at ReactOS, an open source operating system designed to look and feel like Windows. The ReactOS project began in 1996 and was originally envisaged as an open source clone of Windows 95. As later versions of Windows were released, its specifications changed to include the additional features that these versions of Windows brought. As stated on the official ReactOS website, the main goal of the project is to provide an operating system which is compatible with Windows so that people accustomed to the Windows user interface will find using ReactOS straightforward. The ultimate goal is to allow you to remove Windows and install ReactOS without you noticing the change. ReactOS is still considered alpha software, feature incomplete but with some Windows applications already working. It is therefore recommended by the developers only for evaluation and testing purposes. So, without further ado, let's start ReactOS and see what the fuss is all about. So, after the initial installation of ReactOS, this is the first screen that you get to upon the first reboot of the machine. And as you saw from the introduction video footage, the install procedure for ReactOS and the boot screen are pretty much identical to those of Windows XP, and much akin to the Windows 2000 installation process, at this part of setup after the initial reboot, you now have the option to select some variables for your installation environment. So let's just have a quick look through these. So we can set all the standard Windows install features that you get in Windows NT, such as your locale and keyboard layout. So I'll just quickly go through all this. And I'm not going to worry too much about selecting specific options that I want because I'm just installing this build for demonstration purposes. So now that we're at the end of this section of setup, we're just going to press finish and we'll let the installation complete. And after a final reboot, we're now finally at the ReactOS desktop. And as you can see, that pretty much instantaneously booted straight into the desktop environment. Now, taking a look at this at a glance, if you're a regular user, you would be fooled into thinking it was Windows XP or Windows 98, as far as I'm concerned. It defaults to the classic Windows look, so it's very reminiscent of Windows 9X, for example. Now, obviously for me as a massive Windows fan and an advanced user of Windows, this would be quite easy to get used to. This interface, but the main point of ReactOS is that it's easy for someone that's used to using Windows and they can switch to ReactOS and use it exactly the same way as Windows without having to relearn everything. So that's the entire point. Now you do have this other theme. This is not a Windows theme, it's just one that ReactOS comes with. I don't really like it, to be honest. It looks a little bit buggy to me as well. Let's go back to classic. You've got some font size options here, and then you've got your good old Windows Classic color schemes, which are exactly the same as they are in Windows, which is pretty nice. I like this. Why is desert missing? That's peculiar. That was always one of my favorites. And green olive isn't the name of a Windows theme, but it looks like one called spruce. That looks like it's just been renamed, which is rather odd. The high contrast themes are the same again as in Windows. As are these. You've got the pumpkin color scheme, but the good thing about this is it's not gigantic like the one in Windows, so it's actually a regular size with regular size fonts and stuff, because the one in Windows by default is massive. It's got like gigantic fonts. And just like in later versions of Windows, you also have this distinction between the standard and classic Windows themes, because I always prefer the classic one myself. This one is more like the Windows 95 version of the classic theme, whereas this one's more like Windows 2000. Notice that the Windows 2000 version has a slightly lighter grey colour, and it also has the gradient on the title bars, whereas the 95 version doesn't. There's desert, it's called sand. How odd. This one, I think, looks like it's designed to look like... I don't know how to describe this. You know in Windows XP, you have the lunar theme, but then if you have the lunar theme colours and everything, but if you implement it through the classic theme, it looks like this, if that makes any sense. So this is like lunar blue, but as the classic theme. I hope that made sense. Let's go for wheat. That's quite a nice one. Now, I don't know if the start button color is meant to change or not. I'm guessing it is meant to change, but it doesn't. So that ends up looking a little bit out of place if you use any of these themes. Do we have font smoothing? Let's have a look at this. I literally didn't see any difference. I don't know if you did. Let's have a look at these effects. So that's no effect. Let's put on fade. again, I literally can't see any difference. So I'm guessing a lot of this UI is just that, it's like literally UI, it's not actually linked to any sort of code. Now that I've actually gone to the display settings here, I'm going to change the resolution to widescreen and I'm going to recapture the video, so I will be back in a moment. So now that I've recaptured the video in widescreen, let's just take a look around the other parts of the ReactOS UI. So in the bottom corner here, we've got a watermark, much like the one that you'd get in a Windows alpha or beta build. It's got the name of the operating system, the build number, and also underneath it says what version of Windows it's reporting itself as. So at the moment, this version of ReactOS is reporting itself to applications as Windows NT 5.2, which is Windows Server 2003, basically, with the Service Pack 2 installed. So let's have a look at the taskbar properties. So again, this is just like the Windows dialog box. We've got an option to lock or unlock the taskbar. Now, I'm not sure if these are working either. Let's just see. No, I can't add a toolbar. So I can't test that. That's slightly annoying. Auto hide the taskbar. Does that work? No. So again, I think all of these are going to be pretty much the same. It's just a proof of concept, basically. It's not actually any working stuff. That show seconds option is not in Windows. That's quite a nice addition. So at the moment, we've only got the classic start menu option. We don't have the XP start menu option. We don't have any advanced menu options either, but we have the UI, which is nice. We have the adjust date and time dialog box, like the one in Windows. Task manager. Looks like the classic Windows task manager. Excellent. Let's log off and see what happens. So we've got the classic log on dialog box. Can I not log back on now? Am I not allowed? That's rather odd. Can I just like type my name in? No. Okay. So administrator. No. Let's reset the virtual machine. So I'm back in ReactOS after having recovered from that slight problem. And I just realized I haven't looked at any backgrounds yet. So let's see if we actually do have any desktop backgrounds. I'm gonna guess not. No. Although there are some screensavers. So we have this logon screensaver, which is reminiscent of the classic Windows logon screensaver from XP and some other versions of Windows. Notice again, that option hasn't worked. And let's look at 3D text. It isn't letting me. I think it's crashed. Have you crashed ReactOS? Now that is very reminiscent of Windows. Let's restart the virtual machine. You can't get rid of me that easily, ReactOS. So I'm back. Let's have a look at this README. So, what is ReactOS? Open source effort to develop a quality OS that is compatible with applications and drivers written for Windows. That's a pretty ambitious project, to be honest. And if they can like crack that, that would be pretty amazing to have like a fully functional drop-in replacement for Windows that's open source. That would be pretty impressive. So as I said earlier, it says here ReactOS currently focused on Windows Server 2003 compatibility, but they do say it's always keeping an eye toward compatibility with Windows Vista and future Windows NT releases, i.e. 10. And this is quite a good question that I would guess a lot of people watching this video or have heard about ReactOS before would ask. Is it legal? Yes, because the ReactOS developers have written all their code from scratch. They haven't actually taken anything from Windows, which again in itself is pretty impressive. So this is the ReactOS file explorer, and as you can see, it's pretty simple. In fact, it's very reminiscent of the Windows 95 file explorer. There are no quick links on the left hand side, there's no navigation bar, so it literally is like the classic file explorer. As I'm kind of expecting by now, a lot of the options are unavailable, so there aren't any folder options to make. These toggles don't work, neither do these. Well, this one does, but search doesn't. Let's see control panel. Now, if you are a Linux user, you may know about a Windows emulator called Wine, which runs on Linux, and it allows you to very often be able to install and use Windows programs on your Linux machine just as you would in Windows. Now, ReactOS does borrow some of that Wine functionality to get apps running, which we'll look at a little bit later in the video. I'm going to try installing a few apps. Let's just have a look at these control panel applets at the moment. So we've got our system information, ReactOS version 0.5. This is very much like the My Computer dialogue in Windows. Here's the device manager. We don't have any performance options. That's kind of annoying as well, but to be expected. Let's look at user accounts. Let's try adding a user. I don't really want to do this because why is my keyboard not attached to the virtual machine? Is that really going to happen right now? Okay, whatever. Let's just gloss over that. I don't have any sound driver on here. Ah, there's a link to folder options there. Will this work? Yes, you just can't get to it from File Explorer. But I'm guessing these options don't work anyway. Should we see if that worked? Hide extensions for known file types. Okay. It's worse than I thought. But that's okay. I know it sounds like I'm being sarcastic, but I'm not. And it's just crashed. So let's restart the virtual machine. So after that brief look around the ReactOS user interface, let's now have a quick look at how to install applications on ReactOS. Now the easiest way to do this is with the inbuilt applications manager. And basically you open it up and you just have a selection of categories for different software that you can install. So for example, here's Office. So we've got things like Microsoft Word Viewer, we've got OpenOffice. In audio, we've got Audacity and Winamp. We've got Media Player Classic, and so on and so forth. Now, all of these applications will work on Windows. And as I was saying earlier, the whole point of ReactOS is that it's binary compatible with Windows. So these apps here, for example, CCleaner, it will actually download a Win32 app to install. However, I've already done that. So another way of installing apps on ReactOS without the Applications Manager is to get yourself regular Win32 executable files. Now this can be very hit and miss, and to be honest, I've spent quite a long time working out what can and can't install on ReactOS, and out of the pretty decent selection of apps I tried, only these five actually worked. So CCleaner does install, and I'll show you it now. It also works, which is even more useful. So you can analyze and run the cleaner. I'm not going to do it because it tends to make this virtual machine really slow and I end up having to restart it all the time. So I have to be really careful with what I do. FileZilla also works, although I don't seem to have an icon for it, but that does install. In fact, I'll show you the install process for this. So it does say unsupported operating system, but it will say that if you're running anything under Vista, but you can bypass it. So as you can see, the installer is exactly the same because this is the Win32 installer. Now remember, I don't have an internet connection in this virtual machine, so I can't actually demonstrate it in action, but it does open and I'm assuming that it would work. So if you by any chance want to try this out, let me know in the comments. I'd be interested to know whether it does actually work. Then we've got the Klite Codec pack, which I also got installed, and now I also can't find, which is really useful. But that works, and so does Media Player Classic. Opera 36 installed. Where have all these apps gone? Why aren't they in my start menu? They were there earlier, I'm pretty sure they were. Let's just install it again so I can show you. So there we go, we've got Opera 36 installed, and I'm assuming that newer versions will also work. And then lastly, I tried installing the Win98 Plus pack, which was interesting, and it did work. And I'll show you. So the desktop themes app works, and you can select themes. However, for some reason, I don't quite know why, it doesn't show the wallpaper and it doesn't set the wallpaper. It also doesn't set any icons, which I kind of gathered that it probably wouldn't. Same with sound events, I don't think it would set those either. But again, I haven't got a sound card, so I can't verify. But it does set all the colors. So let's just show you this as an example. So it will set you the colors from whatever theme you choose. And it looks like it tries to set the fonts, but it appears to have font substitutes because this should be, I believe, in the travel scheme, it was Comic Sans in the title bars. Obviously, these fonts are different. Oh, actually, I don't know whether they are. I think it's the same font, just different font sizes. Now that I've said that, I can't really tell. So yeah, the only downside of this is that obviously the start button, like I was saying earlier, it doesn't theme with anything else, so it always stays the same color and it looks kind of odd, so I don't like that. So lastly, let's just have a little bit of fun. So we'll see how much like the jungle theme we can get this to look. So let's set the wallpaper manually. Jungle wallpaper. And I don't have a sound card, but will it let me set sounds? Probably not. But, you know, if you had a sound card, you could set all the sounds manually there. So that's that sorted. You could also download the correct font for this theme, which I can't remember what it is. It starts with an M. That's really annoying me now. I can't remember what it's called. But it starts with an M. So you could install that manually yourself. And to be honest, you could get it pretty much looking like whatever theme you wanted. Screensavers. Ooh, what's going on here now? I've got lots of wildlife screensavers. Well, there you go. That one works. But where's the jungle screensaver? Where is it? Let's see if I can set it in here. So ReactOS. Da da da. System 32. Jungle screensaver. Yeah, so it does work. I don't know why it's not coming up in the little box. Is it there now that I've done that? No, peculiar. Yeah. Anyway, so yeah, and that's pretty much it, really. So you can get lots of other apps installed, like I was saying, like OpenOffice and different web browsers. So you could use this, I think, as an everyday system. However, if you did do that, you'd have to bear in mind the limitations, and there are quite a few limitations. It's very hit or miss with executable files. I'm not sure what it's like with games. I did try installing Minecraft and that didn't work. So that doesn't seem promising. Obviously, a lot of the UI is just placeholders and you can't actually change any of the settings, so none of these work. Although the display pictures change, they don't actually do anything. So you have to bear in mind that there are still lots of limitations. It is still an alpha release. It's very early in development. However, the idea is there, and I think with enough developer input, this could eventually become a fully functional Windows replacement, which is actually a really exciting idea. Anyway, that's all for this video. If you enjoyed it, leave a like and subscribe if you haven't already, and I will see you next time.